A couple of years ago, my youngest daughter wrecked her car. It was her first car, and I decided I was going to repair it. And this video documents the entire adventure, which starts with a woman named Pam. We're going to just call her Crazy Pam. And she was headed somewhere. I'm not exactly sure where she was headed, but she was headed there like a bat out of hell. And the girls were at the stop sign turning left. And as soon as they pulled out, bam! They got hit by Crazy Pam. The main thing is no one got injured, but this woman did jump out of her vehicle. She started banging on the driver's side window, screaming obscenities at my children. And luckily, this other lady stopped and got in between Crazy Pam and my kids because she thought that she was out of control. So this is the damage I was left with. The tire and wheel are actually okay, but the rear axle assembly needs to be replaced. The door needs to be replaced, and the quarter panel needs to be replaced. So it's basically totaled. But if I could find a parts car for less than 500 bucks, I was going to give the greenest of lights to this project. Here it is, the perfect car. It was only about an hour away, and it had all the parts I needed. The guy was willing to knock off 100 bucks right off the rip. He would have knocked another 100 off if I would have given him the tires, but I just couldn't figure out how to do that. So the first order of business was taking the axle assembly out, which was really pretty basic, just bolting and unbolting. And then it was on to pulling out the damage, which was knocked in about 2 inches at the worst place.
2 inches.
These are some homemade pull tabs, just whatever I could find here. And the idea is just to weld them on, hopefully not start anything on fire, and start pulling the damage out. It's pretty low tech here. I'm just going to pull it with the tractor. Got about as much as I could with the pull tabs in this location. Check the door. Now I'm going to reset the tabs a little closer to the back of the car. Things are looking pretty good at this point. There's a comparison. Still a little wrinkle right there. This is the bent axle. I took it over to my brother's. We're just going to try to straighten it as much as possible. It actually looked like it was a lot straighter, but I guess it's better than it was. Now it's on to taking the glass out of this car. I would have liked to have kept the rubber seal from this car because it was in better shape than the one from her car. But this was the first time I'd ever done this, and the rubber seal was a casualty on this window. This glass was in better shape. Hers was all scratched up, so I will be using this glass on her car. And now that I've got the glass out of there, it's on to drilling out all the spot welds. And because I'm trying to keep the outside nice, I'm going to drill most of them out from the inside.
Thank you.
I'm going to cut this thing off about 3 inches heavy at the front here. Take the rest of it apart on the bench. Something came loose. I'm taking quite a bit of extra stuff off of the back as well. I'll just take it off up on the bench later. It's still attached. Later on that evening, hallelujah, I finally got this thing off of there. There it is. Now I'm gonna put the pull tabs back on and try to get a little bit more of an upward pull and hopefully get the door to close. And this, some of you can probably tell, is not going to work, but I had to try it. I'm trying to get that last little bit out. It's still about a heavy eighth, maybe a quarter of an inch. And this didn't work, but jerking on a little bit with the tractor made it to where the door would finally close. Oh yeah. There is still that wrinkle, but I'm just gonna move forward right now and get the back glass out of this car. So I have to keep this rubber seal in good shape. And I decided I was going to make a new blade for my Oscar. And this is what I came up with. This blade has just a slight angle on it. And this worked perfectly for the top, the bottom, and almost all of the sides. But as I got closer down to the back, nothing would fit. So the last 11 or 12 inches I couldn't get from the inside, and rather than regrouping and coming up with a better plan, I tried this windshield remover tool that I had bought, and it was a disaster. This thing really didn't do anything but wreck the rubber seal even further. Eventually, I bent an old scraper blade, and it felt like it was about to break, so the plan was to add a little bit of weld in the corner and then weld it to an old blade, creating a 90. And then I could get the last bit of the windshield out from the top side. A thing of beauty. And when you have the right tool, it only takes about 3 or 4 seconds. So basically all I have to do here is put a block of wood in to give me access and then run down the last bit where it's connected. Work like a charm. Yeah, I've got some damage, but I think it'll be okay. Luckily, this is not my Bugatti. Now it's on to taking this quarter panel off, which is exactly as the one before, except I'm not concerned about the outside. I'm going to try to preserve the inside. At this point, I've got most of the quarter panel off. There's a small piece here and there I'll have to get in a little bit. And now I'm on to pulling this inner fender well portion out. I'm going to weld a pull tab on here and make this first pull. This actually worked really well, but it also left two really big holes that I may have to fix. So I'm not sure how much of this I'm going to reuse. So I decided to try something a little less destructive. And I've welded this lag screw eyelet thing onto a pair of vice grips. And now I can hook this on anywhere I want and pull. And this worked fantastic. I was actually surprised at how much it came out. Looked like I knew what I was doing, sort of. Now I'm removing the inner part, along with all the extra parts. I just gotta hunt down all those resistance welds. Had a little bit of rust here, but I got a trick to deal with that. I'll show you here in a minute. So this is the inner fender well, and the plan is going to be to try to use as much of the original one as possible and just stitch a good bit of this new one on here. I'm going to try to pull that dent out a little bit as well. Yeah, I got to take it back outside and try to give it another pull. It's Dum Dum. Now that I've got it up on the bench, I'm going to take all these extra parts off. It's kind of hard to tell how well it fits because it's really not able to go all the way down at the top, but it's looking pretty good. Now I'm cleaning up the inner fender well. The inner fender well has really been in a lot in the front there, so I knew I had to cut it off. I had to keep coming back to this, but I eventually got it out pretty decent, I think. The trick here with the rust is to remove as much as possible mechanically. I used a wire wheel and then saturate it with vinegar. I'm using an old baby diaper, and basically this needs to sit for at least 24 hours. And here, I'm just completely screwing up and cutting way too much off. Huge mistake. This is a little contraption I made to try one more pull. This is just kind of holding the seam there, and I'm just gonna try to pull on it with my truck to get whatever I can. I'm still trying to get that elusive eighth of an inch out. I'm too impatient to wait the full 24 hours without messing with the piece. So you're going to see me coming back to this thing trying to scrub the rust off. But the truth is, 24 hours is not going to go by any faster. It is very important to keep it saturated the entire time. Now that the metal's been saturated with vinegar for 24 hours, I'm going to wash the vinegar off, scrub it with water. It's very important that it doesn't dry. Before it dries, I hit it with phosphoric acid. So again, I wash it off, and then I hit it with phosphoric acid. If you let the vinegar dry, it's going to get this yellow haze on the metal that you really can't get off. This is what I'm calling phosphoric acid, or what I'm using. And now I'm just going to wipe a little bit more on here. And this is ready for paint, rust-free.
This is the first time I've been able to really get it connected good and check my gaps. The inner fender well in the back is really still pushed in quite a bit. All right, so I've made my cut and I've got this thing fit back together. It's a little funky. It's a little bit funky there. Pretty good on this backside, but a little funky right there. The gap itself coming down the door is decent. It's a little tight at the bottom here, but I mean, it's acceptable. Here, I'm working out the metal on the inner fender well, making sure that it matches up perfectly with my good piece, and it's coming along pretty nicely. You remember earlier where I made that big mistake? I've got to rebuild that piece that I cut off, and I'm going to have to use three pieces. So that's going to be fun. It's a bit of a backwards motion, but we're still going to the same place. And one way or the other, we're going to get there. I don't know anything about this weld-through primer stuff. They didn't tell us anything about that when I learned how to weld. But I'll give it a whirl. This is the last piece of this wonderful work of art, and hopefully the end of this happy little accident. It turned out all right. It's a little funky. Now I'm cleaning up the inner fender well, getting it ready to weld, along with all the inner fender well stuff here. So it starts off with those plug welds, and then there's a little lap weld, and then the rest of the whole thing is a butt weld. And I'm not sure why I did this to myself, but that's what I did. So the removal of the quarter panel left some pretty ratty areas, and I thought I could weld up some of the smaller holes with the MIG welder, but I was having the same issues blowing holes and everything. So I jumped back onto the TIG, and I found it was a lot easier to just bore the hole out with the belt sander. Then I could create a little perfectly fitting tab and just TIG the tabs in and cut them off afterwards. So very time consuming, but I did get some practice in on the TIG welder, so it all worked out fine. Now I'm cutting everything off very close. So I finally had the fit up pretty good. I did have this one little weird spot that I had to make a little snip and try to kind of tuck it, kind of a tuck and snip. And it really doesn't matter. This is all the inside of the fender well. I don't know why I was doing a butt joint here in the first place, but I was just getting carried away. So yeah, it starts off here with some plug welds, and then there's a little lap weld, and then the rest of it is all a butt weld. All of this. And here I'm just putting down some magic marker, and now I'm going to use a sharp tungsten and mark this out. Holy, that's what I was thinking. Holy shit, look at all those holes. So yeah, I had to jump off that MIG welder. I don't know if it looks good or not, but it was welded. It's like a mountain chain. Could have been better. Could have been worse. I did have a few pinholes. Had to chase those down at the end. Not too many. I'm a paintbrush kind of guy. Paintbrush and a rattle can. I've never graduated to being an actual painter or even a painter impersonator. This is about as close as I get right here. Now I've got to clean up the quarter panel. And start to fill all of these holes. So there's a whole bunch of holes on this. Same problem, you know, with the MIG welder, I was having the same issue, so I had to jump off of it. Yeah. All these holes that I make with this punch, I have to drill back out a little bit bigger because they're not quite big enough. I think they're only like an eighth of an inch. They need to be a little bigger than that. Thank you.
I don't know how this happened, but I have a gigantic gap there. I mean, it is big. So again, all these holes are punched with that eighth inch punch. I'll have to go back and drill those holes out a little bigger before I can do the plug welds. Now I'm going to go ahead and put some paint on all this stuff. Cover up that primer. And at this point, I've got three big problems. The first one is the inner fender well isn't really fitting that well at the front. The other one is that this rubber seal is supposed to fit in between these two, but around this, and it doesn't really fit that well. And the last thing is this gigantic gap, which I'm basically just going to weld the piece that I cut off back on there, but I'm going to do something crazy here and try to fill this little tiny piece by welding this on edge, which is something I've never done. And apparently it can't be done at 13 amps, so I'm going to have to turn this thing down as low as it'll possibly go, which is 9 amps. And I guess it kind of worked, sort of. So just in case you didn't follow what's going on here, I'm going to weld this piece back on and then cut this piece back off to fill that gap that I had. And then I'll have a nice fit up. Because I can't weld that big gap. I don't know how to weld the hole like that. That's a nice fit up. So I've got it tacked on there and it looks great. Got this bottom part tacked on and it looks great. Now I'm just kind of jumping around doing some stitch welds, and now I've got this done and it looks great. And now I can get ready to cut it back off. I'm just going to sneak up on this cut ever so slowly. And there it is. Now I've got a decent fit up. It was kind of hard to figure that out because it wouldn't really fit right until you cut it. So it is what it is.
It took a lot of massaging here on this inner fender well, especially towards the front, but I finally got it to where I could weld it. Tacked up, looks pretty good. It's a little low right there, but otherwise, looks pretty good. Oh yeah, I tried to do a little TIG welding with that primer stuff and it did not work out. I finally sorted out the MIG welder. The nozzle was loose and that was adversely affecting the welds. I threw a zip tie on it and I was back in business. This area was a little bit further out than I would have liked it to have been, but you know, considering I was just using a tractor and stuff, I don't know, I thought it turned out pretty good, but it was, the gap on the left side of the trunk was a tiny bit wide. There it is, all welded off. Sorry for the speedy, shaky camera stuff. The gaps are okay. It's got a little bit of a wideness right there, but otherwise it's not terrible. Especially right there, but what are you gonna do? little Bondo action. Just happens to be the paint that I had on hand. That and the primer and the black paint is just stuff that I already had. I didn't really want to spend any unnecessary money on this project. I've already spent enough. As long as it doesn't corrode, it should be fine. Now I'm going to clean up the good glass and get rid of this rubber seal. I'll have to take the rubber seal off of the bad glass, which is this rubber seal. And this is the rubber seal I'm going to have to use. And it's pretty rough. It's got overspray on it, so I'm going to just paint it with this trim and bumper paint stuff, just to at least make it all the same color. It wouldn't really stay on there too well, so I ended up using some flashing tape. I cut a whole bunch of little pieces of zip tape and just pulled it towards the inside, and that kept it on there. You know, once the sealant's on there, it should be fine. This is a dry run, and everything looks good. Now I'm getting everything ready for some seam sealer. It's been out in the sun, so it's nice and warm. Now I'm just going to seal up all the cracks. I got a little carried away back here. I just rolled with it. This is some special primer that goes with the windshield sealant. I'm not sure what makes it special. This is the windshield sealant. And the trick here is to cut a little triangle. That way you can squirt out a little witch hat mountain range. You just want to make sure you don't have any gaps. And I think it took like two tubes. And here it is. The final fit. I also ended up using the sealant to fix inside here where I had that little gap around that rubber seal. And then also just a couple of questionable places on the window rubber seal. And that's it. Got her done, son. Got her done. Unfortunately, this story has two endings. This is the happy ending. This is my favorite ending. I got a call one morning, right after she left for school. Papa, I wrecked my car. I don't even know what to say. So, the main thing is that no one got injured, physically. Emotionally, mentally, I was rattled. Took me a while to finish this edit. I like happy endings. I was happy with the happy ending. It is what it is. I'm not even sure what the moral of this story is. Maybe it's that kids are expensive and they can ruin just about anything. So be careful. You don't want to kill them. But you don't want them to kill you. It's a matter of balance and harmony. So choose your battles, my friend, and choose them wisely. Until next time, if you happen to know the moral, please let me know.